TV. This is the second episode of the course GNS221, computer and its application. GNS221, computer and its application. So last episode we talked about the history of computers, some inventions, inventors, the generations of computer. Now today we go to the computer system. But before we touch the computer system, I'd like to emphasize on some point. For instance, the father of computer. We know that the father of computer is Charles Babbage. Due to the major contribution, Charles Babbage. He contributed a lot to the system, development of computer. He invented the first computer, which is called the analytical machine, in the year 1840. And he was a mathematician. He has a friend. She's a female friend called Lady Ada Lovelace. Now that friend was an amateur mathematician, and she's regarded as the first programmer. That is the first person that helped to write set of instructions that guides the activities of the computer. That is the first programmer. The first programmer is known as what? The first programmer is Lady Ada Lovelace. Now I want us to know something. We need to know all these things, the first programmer, because it can come out. Now one thing again is that she helps in writing what we know as programming. So it is a different topic entirely on its own, programming. So now the program is just a set of instructions. It's just a set of instructions that guides the activities of the computer. That is what will enable the computer to carry out a function. It is this woman that first helps us to write or gives us the tip about it. The friend of Charles Babbage. Now we go to the next, to what we are in for today. I told us today, at the end of today's class, we should be able to know what the computer system is all about. Now, if we're talking about the computer system, is made up of three components. That is, there are three components of the computer system. We have the first one, we have the hardware. We have the second one, we have the software, the third one, the human way. Now this computer system is made up of three components. We have the first one, the hardware. The hardware, the software, and the human way. Now we'll go with the first one, which is hardware. What are hardware? Hardware are the physical component of the computer that you can see visibly and touch. That is, there are some parts of the computer that you can see and touch. You just see the computer like this, you see something like this, you know. There are some components of this computer that you cannot see or touch. There's a component that you cannot see or touch. You have the monitor, you can see them. You have the keyboard, you can see them. You have the speakers, the mouse, you can see them. But there are some things that are internal that you cannot see. But today, for this aspect, we are dealing with these things that we can see and touch. These things that we can see. Oh, this is the mouse. Oh, this is the keyboard. This is the keyboard. This is the monitor. This is the speaker. This is the light pen, etc. Dealing with the things that we can see and touch. The hardware, that is things that can be seen and touched. Now, we go to the hardware in full. Hardware is made up of two things. It's made up of two components. It's divided into two. We have the system unit. The system unit and what we call the peripheral. The system unit and what? The peripheral. Note, the system unit is also known as the what? Central processing unit. You come here and say, okay, we have something as big as this. You can have it like this. This is the what? The CPU, central processing what? Central processing unit. The system unit, the system unit is also known as what? The CPU. Note, the system unit is subdivided into what? Into three units as well. You need to take note of this. We said this hardware is subdivided into two. The what? The system unit and the what? Peripheral. System unit is subdivided into two as well. Into three rather. We have the what? The control unit. Control unit. Arithmetic and logic unit. ALU. Arithmetic and logic unit. And we have the storage unit. We have the control unit, the arithmetic and logic unit, and we have the storage unit. Now let's go with the first one, the control unit. From the word control, this control unit is the one that helps to deal with the issuing of commands in the computer. Anything that has to do with what? Transfer of commands. You know, you are done with your work, you want to save, control S. You are done with your work, you want to enter into a text, enter. That is, you are sending a command. Now, what deals with that aspect is the control unit. Control P, you are commanding the computer what? To print out the document that you have actually worked on. Control, there is a particular aspect of the computer that deals with that part, the control unit. Now, go to the next one without wasting your time. Arithmetic and logic unit. Think about it. Arithmetic. What is arithmetic? Arithmetic has to do with what? Calculations of some terms. Calculations, multiplications, subtraction, addition, all of these. When we hear about the word logic, logic means what? Reasoning. That is calculation, reasoning, trying to figure out some fact, unit. So this is the unit that deals with what? Calculation in the computer. A lot of people are what? Not very comfortable with the package called Microsoft Excel. You want to do calculations, you will make use of what? This unit. It is the unit that helps us what? To do all those things. A lot of people want to write mathematics textbooks. Okay, once you write it, you want to print it out, you perform some calculations there, it gives you answer directly. It is arithmetic and logic unit what? That deals with that. The next one, the storage unit. The storage unit is the unit that deals with the storing of files in the what? In the computer. Let's go. I want you to know that this storage unit is very broad and it is divided into two. We have the primary storage. We're talking about the storage unit here. The storage unit is divided into two. We have the first one, the primary storage. The primary storage. The primary storage. And we have the second one, we have the secondary storage. Secondary storage. Now take the first one, the primary storage. Now the primary storage refers to the internal storage of the what? Of the computer. The main storage that follows the what? Suits the computer, the production of the computer. When you get your phone, without putting the SD card, the memory card, you have an inbuilt what? Memory inside that phone. Now that is what we're talking about, primary storage. When they're saying primary, the beginning, without you adding something, the what? The starting, the foundation. That phone that you're holding has a what? A primary storage of either 4 gig or 5 gig or 6 gig or 3 gig. Before you can now say, I'm not contented with this, I need to get a memory card, a SD card, a flash drive of what? Of 500 gig, of 32 gig, and the likes. That is what the primary storage is what? Is all about. The primary storage is what? Is of two types. The primary storage is what? Is of two types. We can have the what? We can have the RAM. We can have the what? And the ROM. That is, there are two types. We can have the what? The RAM. And the ROM. Now, if you are talking about these two, they are different. That what? They are different. They have different characteristics. They have different what? Functions. If you are talking about the RAM is a primary storage in the computer that helps to store information
that is ongoing, that is present information that you are using at that particular time. For instance, you switch on your computer, you are here to get a flash drive, you are here to get a flash hard disk, but you know that once you get your computer, there is a Follicom storage there. Now, while you are working, even without you saving that work, there is a RAM that helps to save all those works that you are doing. For instance, you are typing a document, okay, now you copy it, you go into another place, you want to go and paste there. There is something that helps you to work, to store that information as you've copied it there. So once you go to another place to paste it, it will appear. Now the problem is that once there is change in power, maybe NEPA took the light, you know, something like that, the information will be lost and it can never be regained again. Once your phone got switched off, the information that you copied, if you try to click on something that you want to paste it, it will be lost. That is what the RAM is all about. It has to store information, present information. Now let's go to the what? The full meaning is what? Random access memory. I think we know that. Now the ROM is the type of, it's just a primary storage that helps to store the firmware information of the computer, the user information of the computer, the manufacturer information of the computer that cannot be accessed, that cannot be altered by what? By the user. For instance, when you get your phone, there are some information that has been stored under that phone. If you check your storage settings, you might say, this phone is 8 gig. You will notice that out of that 8 gig, they have divided 4 gig. They've removed 4 gig from your own. That you are left with what, 4 gig. They will tell you that that 4 gig is what, system what, for system storage. You have a lot of application under that 4 gig. That is all these things you cannot alter them. If you format your phone, all those things will not be deleted. Wonder it. If you try to check it, there are some apps that even if you format your phone, you will still find it there. They are under what, ROM, because they cannot be accessed by the owner of that what, phone. They are being programmed there by the manufacturer of that computer or of that phone or of that accessory. Now we have examples. We can have the what, this is read only memory. We can have the what, EEPROM. We can have the what, PROM. We can have the EEPROM. This is electrical programmable. Take note of all these things can come out. That I saw them in some videos. Programmable read only memory. Now we have this as programmable read only memory. Now this one, electrical alterable programmable read only memory. That's now what on the primary storage. Now going to the secondary storage refers to the complementary aspect of storage. That is, for instance, you don't like this storage, that it is not enough for you. You now decide that I need to get what, an additional storage, what, to serve as a backup for what, the primary storage. That is what the secondary storage is all about. So the secondary storage is just like the backing storage. That is secondary storage. Storage is just like a backing storage for the primary storage. The backing storage for the what? Backing storage for the primary storage. It's not like the what? The backing storage what? For the primary storage. That is this secondary storage. For instance, we have the hard disk, the memory cards, the flash drive for the what? The compact disk, floppy disk, hard drive for your what? For your computer. So now,
Now, let's talk about the last one, which is the peripheral aspect of the word, of the hardware. You know, I said we have the system unit and the peripheral. Now, the peripheral refers to the what? To the major part of the hardware, that is things that must be attached directly or indirectly to the computer to enable it to function. Note that it's this monitor is not the computer. The what? Speaker is not the computer. The keyboard is not the computer. The what? But what is the computer? The combination of everything. You have some cables that will be attached. That is what we know as the what? The computer. So now under the peripherals, we have some units. We have what? We are very familiar. We have the input unit, the output unit, the input unit and the output unit. For example, the input unit, what you are going to input into the computer, we have the what? Something like the mouse, you plug it into the computer, the cables, you plug it, the keyboard, you will plug it into the what? Into the computer. All those cables, all those things, they are what? They are referred to as what? What? Input devices. Input. Now we have the next one, which is the output devices. If you are talking about the output devices, things that helps you to bring out information from the computer. We have the printer. Printer will help you to print out furnished books or documents out from the computer. We have the speaker, it helps to bring sound. The monitor is an output device, it brings out visual what? Visual things for you to what? For you to see. So I think that is not only peripheral aspect of what? Of the computer. So the next episode, we will dwell more on the software and the humanware aspect of the computer system. Please like and subscribe, as your likes and subscription motivate us to do more. Don't forget to share.